Okay, so the way I see Intel over the next 4 years, we've started the journey very well, like I said, in the last 6 months, and we aim to continue to grow that throughout this year. We expect to exit this year at over 1 million subscribers through our marketing plan and our sales plans. That's definitely on target for that. And then over the next couple of years, we'll continue to grow very strongly. We'll have a full national 4G network, as I mentioned before, where most of the competition as well would have started to roll out their network. But we have that first mover advantage, and I'm very keen that we leverage on that first mover advantage and become what Nitel was always meant to be, which is a fully integrated telecommunications organization, where we have full optimization of our SAT3 cable. We have a very, very strong and promising enterprise unit. In addition to that, we have a strong wholesale and transit business. All of these need to be optimized. They're there. And I've mentioned earlier on before that it's our strong desire to have our own fiber ring around Nigeria, all around Nigeria, and all of those last mile opportunities, so that we become, as I said before, the BT of Nigeria. So that's a good question. So I think yeah, there is a view that there was a view when I came back that the current industry was kind of stagnated and wasn't really moving. It wasn't really moving forward. But you see, that's because the 2G services in Nigeria has become, it's proliferated. Everybody's on 2G, 3G. And what happened in the UK, right now in the UK, we have only a few hundred thousand subscribers that are on 2G. Most people are on 3G, in fact 4G now. So what's happening is it's consumer-led, it's demand-led. I was in Port Harcourt recently, and I was taken to some developments, massive developments, where all of the homes are being built with smart technology, Internet of Things. We've seen it with smart fridges. We've seen it with the real surge in Netflix. So people now want data for a variety of uses. What Nigeria does and what Africa does is it doesn't always have to follow the evolutionary path of the UK, right? We don't really have fixed lines in Nigeria, not to the extent that we have in the UK or in the States. But we can leapfrog some of those technologies, and it's happening. So with the demand for data-centric products, it will drive everything. So I believe, and that's why all the ecosystem players are building 4G networks in order to cope for this demand. 2G will die off in Nigeria in the same way it's dying and it's practically ended in the UK. Nobody really uses 2G phones. And the same is going to happen here. So there will be a resurgence of the telco players and the ecosystem offering 4G-centric services to our customers, the quad plays, online TV. I mean, I have Netflix at home, and when my DStv ran out, I didn't even bother to renew it because it was all run off my hotspot from my phone, you know? So I see that being the way forward. I think that the industry here, with our population, and with our strong, I think, what, 70% of the youth are under the age of 30, this is where the demand is going to come from. And we're in the internet generation. Everybody's been exposed to Facebook, everybody's been exposed to all of these new contents and providers, and it's all data-driven. So I believe that this industry is going to be the resurgence of Nigeria.